Now we're back on the third fucking camera. That's three. The Jager's setting in, man.
Third camera.
So, but you know what? That's a true measure of success. That's what we were talking about during the break. Is going after a goal and just working diligently towards that goal. That's a true measure of success. It's not staying in one place saying, oh, well, we're taking a step back and saying, screw it, I'm throwing in the towel, I can't do it. I don't even know what that means. Yeah, that word can't is not my vocabulary. I don't know what the fuck it means.
Can't is a word that can't be there.
Yeah, see, that was worse than Greek for me. I couldn't understand that. Yeah, exactly. You know why? Because can't is not my vocabulary. So, yeah.
All right.
Yeah, true measure of success is going after your goal. I'm working hard to get it. See ya.
Speaking of that, if you weren't a wrestler or anything along those lines, what else was your career path? Were you technical or desk job?
You ever see Joe Dirt? Can I have a radio station?
Yeah.
So I'd be.
Gotcha.
No, I would wrestler is it.
Yeah, that's it.
No plan B.
Nice.
However, anything in the entertainment field, actor.
Okay.
Which is what I'll be getting into as well.
Sorry, I may have lied to you. I may have a little more than three questions.
I don't have a lie to
you. I won't make it too late. I'm trying to think about some more.
You got about 30 minutes.
That being said, what other shows or performances or anything like that have you been in? Shows, movies, anything like that?
I did a short film for NYU, New York University.
Yep. We set up a gym.
Really?
Yeah.
It's called Eat My Pie. It's on youtube.com/TheRealJKO. I played a supporting role. I wanted the lead role, but the producers were like, no, you'd be better for the supporting role. I'm a fucking lead man. But honestly, it was the better role.
Sweet.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
You should check it out.
I will, like, sure.
Oh, and the MTV thing was
MTV,
on that.
That's right.
And then, there's probably gotta be several chicks with videos in their house or something. I'm kidding.
Bullshit.
Well, one time I was like, what the fuck is that? And then the girl was just like, it's not a camera. I'm like, I never mentioned the word camera. But she actually showed me. It was like a mini boombox.
It
was like, plays radio. I'm like, I don't know. I know what happened to Hogan. Brother.
You know, I've been to his bar downtown? The bar?
Really?
Yeah, oh yeah. You ever been there?
No.
It's right like downtown Tampa, Clearwater.
I know,
yeah. Literally called the bar.
Wow. And Hogan runs it?
He used to, actually. I believe he sold it a couple years ago, but he did. He owned it, opened it.
Oh, shit, brother. I call girls brother, too. Brother, sister, brother.
What's the worst job you've ever had?
Private sanitation. Yeah. Because
what does that entail? That sounds interesting.
Sanitation, garbage man, right?
Right.
Picking up people's garbage and shit. But private sanitation, you pay an extra fee, and they'll throw whatever the fuck you need to get thrown out. In regular sanitation for the city, they separate, you know, the recyclables,
right,
and regular garbage or whatever, and certain things you can't throw out. Private is just like, put it in a black bag, we pick it up, throw it out, we'll dispose of it.
Gotcha.
You know, it's run by the fucking Italian mob, you know what I mean?
Whatever, yeah.
So it's like, yeah, we take care of it, you know what I mean? But the worst fucking job. And then I got it, I did it for 2 weeks, hated it. We picked up double the amount of garbage that the actual city would allow.
Right.
So it was back-breaking work, man. I mean, we're talking about 29 tons of garbage in under an 8-hour night. I mean, constantly moving. I mean, you don't have a chance to eat. You don't have a chance to take a piss. We were taking pisses behind dumpsters and stuff.
Yeah.
Some gas stations would allow us to have a snack because we were picking that stuff up. I'm like, I'm going to eat this with all this shit on my hands. Like, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I had this one time we pulled the latch down and it just like crushes the garbage and all this chicken like jizz just went all over my face.
Oh,
holy shit. That was the beginning of the night. I needed the money. I had to work. I had my rent. You know, I'm a young guy. And it got to the point where hanging on the back of the truck, I got like a $100 ticket, which is like my pay for the entire night. I'm like, fuck, it ain't worth it. And I actually said to the owner, the manager, I was like, look at his face. I was like, I don't belong here. I was like, I belong on TV or something. I can't do this anymore. He was like, this kid's got something. But hey, I, you know.
You do what you gotta do in the time.
Hard to argue with it, yeah.
Yeah.
There's some more chocolate in here.
And I think the last question that I really was wondering to get answered, what's the best place you've ever lived? Or your favorite, best, however you want to phrase it. Because I'm sure home has its own separate little spot, even though, you know, you don't like Brooklyn that much or whatever it may be, you don't like New York that much.
I don't have an
issue. I'm sure it still has a...
I'm a very unsettled person. I'm a nomad. I'm a wanderer. I don't know. I don't have an answer for that.
No.
No, I'm never.
I got something on you there.
You actually got me to think about that. Yeah. Well, I'm always kind of thinking.
Right.
I don't need anybody else to do that. But yeah, I'm never satisfied.
That's always there's something more, something better, something.
Yeah, I don't want to just go into the grave and just be okay. I want a fucking baseball slide into it and be like, woo, what a ride. You know what I mean?
Right.
So I just I guess I'm just looking for the next fun thing, man.
Gotcha, it's still on the hunt for it.
What was that?
Still on the hunt for it.
I actually want to move to LA next.
Yeah?
Los Angeles, California, probably around Santa Monica. I don't know. I'm supposed to be moving with a buddy, but he's a good dude, but he's just kind of unreliable.
Gotcha. You
know? And I may end up having to go down there by myself, so.
Well, I wish the best of luck to you.
Thanks, man. The best of luck to you. In fact, you know, real men don't fucking need luck. We make shit happen.
Of course.
Yeah. So I know whatever it is you plan on doing, you will do.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Maybe next time I'll be interviewing you. Never know.
That'd be a hell of a turn of the tables there, I guess.
Yeah.
That'd be cool, huh?
Yeah. So what about you? What's your favorite place to live?
See, I lived in New York, I lived in Colorado for 2 years, but that was my first 2 years of life, so I really don't remember it that much. And I've been in Florida for a year and a half, and I think my favorite place is Florida.
Nice.
Out of the four spots so far.
I got something. Now you're making me think even more, because you said something about you got something. I mean, I'm like, fuck. I'm like, I gotta make the one-two kick out, shoulder up. My favorite place to live would have to be Paradise. Paradise is where everyone's happy. Currently, that's the city of champions. How
I like that.
And how aptly named for a champion. So
of course.
You're right there with it, man. Champion. Champion.
So I think that's about all the questions I had. And thank you very much for the interview.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming by.
Yeah, man. Let's appreciate get some Buffalo Wild Wings.
Sounds good.
Jàger.
One more.
Shot.
Yeah, let's say one more. Before we sign off.
I wouldn't be a gentleman if I didn't offer you first, so. This guy brought a whole canister of freaking, I don't know if canister is the right word, but a whole, I'm talking.
Whole cooler. Much.
Cooler. Yeah, that is pretty cool. It's cooler than just having one drink. There's a lot of drinks in there.
You know what I'm using for ice packs, by the way?
What?
Frozen water bottles.
Beautiful. Nice.
You
should have used frozen beers, man, because you can guzzle them after they thaw out.
Jager.
But this has been fun, man. Anytime you want to shoot the shit again.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much, Johnny Knockout. The one and only.
Blaze, Mike.
You can catch him on WWE sometime.
And best fortunes and best wishes to you in your interviewing career. I know you'll be great.
I appreciate it.
Best
to
you as well.
We'll see you later.